give him all the glory that is due unto him. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, we worship you, Lord. Lord, we come into your presence this morning, Lord Jesus, with a thankful heart. Lord, thankful for what you have done in our lives, Lord. Thankful for your mercy and grace in our lives. Thankful, Lord, that you are the one who is guiding us, keeping us, Lord Jesus. Lord, I pray that, Lord, help us this morning, Lord, to join, Lord, with the creation and worship you. Lord, to glorify your name as we worship, I pray that, Lord Jesus. Lord, let your name, Lord, be filled in our hearts. And Lord, let that overflow, Lord, into, Lord, the surrounding, Lord, areas, Lord, and the hearts of people, Lord, who are hearing us. Lord, let your name be glorified, Lord, in this city. Lord, let your name be glorified, Lord, in this nation. That's our prayer, Lord Jesus. Lord, as we worship, as we bring glory to your name, Lord, you take pleasure in our worship this morning, Jesus. We thank you, Lord, Jesus.
Thank you. cross that leaves no question of the measure of His love. Our chains are gone, our debt is paid, the cross has overthrown the grave. For Jesus' blood that sets us free leads death to death and life for me. The innocent judged guilty, but the guilty one walks free. Death would be his portion, and our portion liberty. Our shame's gone, our debt is paid. Give my whole life to honor this love. So by the Lamb who was slain, I'm forgiven. The sinner's Savior, crowned Him forever. So for the Lamb who was slain, He is. I give my whole life.
My debt is paid because of what He has done on the cross. Because of His love, He came into this world. Are we ready to give our life completely, completely to surrender to Him? What else can we give? There is nothing in this life that we can give Him. to thank him enough for what he has done. But we can do one thing. Take a decision that, yes, Lord, this life that you have given me, I do not own it. I bring it all to you. I want to live according to your will. I want to do what you want me to do. I want to build my life upon that foundation. In Jeremiah 42, we read about a small group of Israelites who were left in the land after the Babylonians came and captured the land. And they are in a state where they don't know what to do. And they go to Jeremiah and say, "Can you please pray for us? Can you please find out from God what he wants us to do?" Wanting to do God's will is one thing. It's very good. God will be pleased in that. But if you read that chapter, Jeremiah agrees to pray for them. He prays. And God answers.